Okay, so homework one. What I'd like you to do is make a web page with a form on it that lets you Rot13 some text. First, I'll explain what Rot13 is. Okay, so Rot13 is a simple cipher to run a simple encryption algorithm on some text. And so it looks something like this. Okay, if I were to check this string hello and apply Rot13 to it, it would look like this. U-R-Y-Y-B. And what I've done is I've incremented every letter by 13. So H becomes U, E becomes R, L becomes Y, and O becomes B. So if I had an alphabet, like so, if I were to convert each letter, I increment them by 13. So A moves 13 spaces and becomes N. Or H moves 13 spaces and becomes U. And Z wraps around moving 13 spaces and becomes M. So if you were to apply a Caesar cipher to itself, you get the string you originally typed in. So it's not the fanciest cipher in the world, but we're not trying to test your cryptography skills. There's another class for that. I'm just trying to test your web handling skills. Let me show you what this should look like when it's all working. Okay, so here is the app running on my AppSpot account at /unit2/rot13. And if I type some text in this field and click submit, it re-renders this form with my text in the text box. And if I were to hit submit again, it converts it back to hello. Okay, this is what I'd like you to build. A couple things to notice. One is that it preserved case. So the capital H became a capital U, and the lowercase lo became the lowercase r, y, y, and b. I'd also like you to preserve punctuation. So I've expanded my text here to have an exclamation mark and a question mark. And when I Rot13 this, it preserves the exclamation mark and the question mark, and everything else becomes Rot13. And you know it's working because when you run it again, you get the original text. I'd also like you to preserve whitespace. Okay? I've added some whitespace and another exclamation mark, and everything worked. And here's one thing to look out for. Remember, you might need to escape some HTML. Now, this box here, this box for the text, is using an element we haven't talked about. It's called a text area. And it's another form element for entering large pieces of text. If I were to include this in my text field and not escape it properly, we could have problems. But as you can see, I've escaped my less thans and greater thans properly, so everything works. And I can go back to text area and all as well. Now this is running online, so you can verify what my expectations are by playing around with my own version at this URL. You can also, if you want, view the source of this page to see the HTML I was using to, you know, draw the bigger box and that sort of thing. It's fine if you want to use that. What I want you to do is implement the backend part, and once you have it working, I'd like you to enter the full URL where it's running here. Now, when we grade this, it's a little challenging. So, you know, obviously we're not going to be able to grade how it looks. We're going to have an automated script that submits some data and looks at the response. Make sure you follow the notes below to have the correct input name. So when I submit directly to your form, I can find my text in the result. Okay, good luck.